Some of the most famous fashion designers in the U.S. today have been asked to forecast what Eve will look like in A.D. 2000. One idea is a dress that can be adapted for morning, afternoon, or evening. It's the sleeves, what does it? Apparently, in A.D. 2000, we shall be having a hair-raising time. Yet another designer goes so far as to believe that skirts will disappear entirely. Shoes will have cantilever heels, and an electric belt will adapt the body to climatic changes. The lightly clad woman of tomorrow, ooh, swish, will move in an atmosphere that's scientifically kept at the right temperature. The future bride in a wedding dress of glass. What the groom will wear, apart from a worried look, isn't mentioned. A dress of aluminium, with a sash to change it for afternoon or evening, and an electric headlight to help her to find an honest man. As for him, if he matters at all, he'll be fitted with a telephone, a radio, and containers for coins, keys, and candy for cuties.
No one can clearly foresee the city of the future. But the appearance of any city, of any period of history, is a direct outcome of the social, economic, and technical conditions then existing. The cities of the future would be laid out to a master plan. Streets and buildings no longer haphazard, but harmoniously related. Structural ingenuity would, of course, go on producing unusual forms, perhaps suspension bridge apartment houses. These would surely provide wide vistas for the bridge dwellers and perhaps gratify the very human desire for novelty and romance. There must be broad avenues, providing trees and ease of movement, with light and pure air for all buildings. Perhaps the master stroke of planning would be to segregate, on one hand, future highly efficient automatic industrial centers, producing all our needed goods and distributing them in abundance. New centers of leisure would arise, around which we would live, fully participating in the sports, the arts, and the sciences, in fact, in all the activities which make life worth living. Here's a peep through a future window of the world. This monster plane will carry 600 passengers, and the huge wing and double fuselage houses luxurious lounges and reading rooms. It will speed from London to New York in a day. Future aerodromes will be centers for highway, sky, and rail carriers. Landing on top of the huge aerodrome, planes will taxi to a ramp, descend to a lower level, and discharge their passengers. At still lower levels, motor highways, railroads, and pneumatic mail tubes will have terminals.